Hi, we have some tales to tell you in the workshop coming up now. Hey guys, welcome to the workshop. Today we are going to work on some miniatures from the board game Tales from the Loop. Let's see if I can get that. There we go. Tales from the Loop, the board game. And it's done by the wonderful people at Free League. Oh, let's see, there we go. Free League and Dust. Free League also does some other fantastic games, some RPG games, I should say. One of the particular ones that I'm really liking right now is the, I believe it's the Alien, the Alien role-playing game. It's fantastic. All right, so what we are going to do is we are going to work on these guys. They're little. You got Alpha and Beta. And we're going to work on the two of those guys. What I'm going to do first, let's take some. These have been all. These have been primed. Well, these have been primed with White Scar primer from Citadel Paints from Games Workshop. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to make everything just a little bit more solid, at least on one of them, with the white from Duncan's Two Thin Coats. So you can see it's pretty decently white, but I want as white as it can get. We're going to go and go over it with white paint. Just to brighten everything up a little bit. Also, it helps cover over any spots I may have missed. Or, you know, was a little thin on the white primer. This is kind of a little bit different for me. I'm usually not used to working in whites. I think it'll look good once it's all done. Especially once when we start getting the other colors on it. It's gonna start looking amazing, I think. We're going to stop there for that one anyway. We'll go and we'll do the other one later. But we're going to continue on this guy right here. Now, this is a Paarhufer Mark 79. And again, this is from the board game Tales from the Loop, which apparently is also a pretty decent TV show. It's on my list of things I will get to, but have not yet. All right, so we're going to start with this guy right here. And then we're going to do some really cool stuff a little bit later on. Again, we use Duncan Rhodes Painting, the Painting Academy, the two thin coats. We're going to use Rust Orange. The other color that we had used for the white was just White Star. Now, these machines have some decorative striping on the side. So what I am going to do, I'm going to take my trusty pencil and I am going to draw kind of a representation of where the lines are supposed to go. There we go. So as you can see, I've just kind of penciled in where the lines are supposed to, or where the orange is supposed to go. We're going to put it on a handle. There we are. And let's take our detail brush. Very carefully. Cover the spots that need to be orange. And then as far as the stripe, goes. We'll fix it up. Again, we're taking our time. There we go. And that side will tidy up a little bit with, you know, afterwards. But there is definitely more orange that we need to do. And, away we go. And as so we're just kind of, you know, going along. Trying to figure out. All the different colors. Figure out where all the different, yeah, where all the different colors go. Trying to make sure to everything's nice and solid. I think you'll be a cute little fellow when he's all painted up. At least my way of thinking, anyway. No, but as far as, miniatures go, they're not bad. You know, they're a single piece cast. Or if they are put together, I don't know where they are put together. We just go over the, again, go over the spots just to make sure that the paint is a nice even coat. And I'm using the character card from the game to get the colors. How the colors go on the robot. Yeah, but like I said, these are single piece miniatures, pre-assembled, ready to play out of the box. You don't have to do anything to them if you don't want to. I mean, they just come as your standard gray plastic. That's all right. Nothing wrong with that. If you want to add a little, add a little spice or life to your board game other than the boring gray. And these are your miniatures, these are your games. Paint them if you want to. Nobody's going to tell you you can't. Or at least I won't. And these are painting up pretty dark quick, actually. So that's the card that I'm using. That's the card that I'm getting the paint detail or the color details from. If we're gonna paint them up and make them look cool, kind of want to make them look right. Or, at least try to. Things are looking smashing with this. turning out quite nice. Yeah, you know, like I said, they're actually painting up pretty quickly. At least a little quicker than I kind of expected them to. Yeah. No, I didn't bother to clean up the models. That's not really. Huge deal. Every now and then you just kind of have to poke around until you find the right angle. Get that brush in there. There we are. That's pretty much the orange done. Again, it's just going over making sure you got all the spots so you don't have the glaring white unpainted part. They said we do have another one. Yeah, this guy right here. And it will be painted up exactly the same way as we're doing the first one. The first one's more kind of a test run to see how everything looks anyway. So now I'm doing Iron Warriors from Citadel Paints. Because there are metallic parts on this guy, and we have to make sure they get done too. basically what we're doing. And now we're just the toes. And we'll be going back in and doing some finer detail in a bit. Right now, we're just going to do some large filled in areas. Get all that all those toes done. I mean, if you want, you can do this part black if you want, but I thought it'd be neat to kind of give it a more metallic look to it while still, you know, keeping with the spirit of the mini. You know, and I'm not too worried about making a mess on the base because we're going to cover up that base. Something different. Yeah. I got the toes done, but there's more yet to come. But we're actually not going to worry about doing that right now. I have got a whole new range of paints. Well, at least a sample of their paints anyway. From a company called Turbo Dork. Right there. And I am looking forward to getting into these paints right here. And the best part is that it tells you what the best base coat to use is. So this color, which is called Dark Net, it says on it that, of course, you should shake well. Of course, with any paints, you should shake them up. Must be used over a black base coat to see the shift effect. So I am interested in seeing what that's all about. But what I am excited to see is a color called Multipass, which is orange. And it says actually right on it, it says use over orange base coat for most vibrant results. So what we're going to do is we are going to hit this guy here, or at least parts of him, with this multi-pass paint from Turbo Dork. And we are going to see how it looks. And I don't know if you saw, but they come in a nice drop nozzle. It's fantastic. Now, I'm just going to use this paint straight at first before I go ahead and try and thin it down or anything like that. And what we are going to do, we are going to hit the body. And it does say to use several thin coats. So what we're going to do is we're just going to kind of move on to other parts. While the other coats dry. It's kind of cool. It's gives it a very shiny, very metallic look. Very metal flake. Kind of hot rod. I actually kind of like it. I think it's kind of neat. I can see it definitely being used for these paints being used for kind of a yeah, you can use it for just certain parts on a miniature, or you can just go whole hog and just do the whole. Whole shebang. Right now, I'm just kind of do the main body. I'll leave the rest of the, the rest of it sort of the regular orange, but I do kind of like how the I do like the sparkle, the metallic fleck of it. And because of that, so I think we are going to take some black. Going to paint other parts. We're going to use some more of the turbo door paint. Let's see what we can come up with. Nice and delicate. Some of the spaces that we're gonna get into. I think things are coming along quite swimmingly. Things are going quite nice. Now we only got a couple minutes left. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a big splash black. Right here. And we're going to see what happens when we use some of that other turbo dork paint. Because now I am curious as all heck. There we are. Right, so we're just going to leave. There's a lot more I have to do, but that's okay. Oh, dark net. Course, give it a quick shake. Pop some of that out. And then we are going to So we've already painted. Huh. Kind of gives me the a little bit more of a, an actual metallic sheen. Then the Citadel Iron Warriors one. Not bad, actually, how it looks. Alright. Anyway, we are going to continue on with these guys when we come back to the workshop. So, in the meantime, be safe, stay safe, most of all, paint safe, and we'll see you next time in the workshop.